Hello and welcome to another episode of Boldly Going, where we discuss the various Star Trek series. I am Merlin, sometimes known as Joe, and I've got the film fanatics here with me. I've got Dan over there.
Hey.
Got Justin over here.
How's it going?
And today we're going to be talking about the DS9 series, which I love, an early episode in season one called Move Along Home. And Dan is going to do the synopsis because he usually doesn't talk about DS9.
That's probably true.
Yeah.
All right, well, in this episode, you'll have to tell me the name of these people.
The Voon or
something.
It's the first
short name.
It's the first alien race they meet in the quadrant from the wormhole. So, okay. So it's like a big deal.
Yeah. Well, so they meet these people, and all they want to do is go see Quark and play some games. And so four of the crew members find themselves basically in sort of like a limbo area. They don't exactly know where they are, but they have to play these games to stay alive. And Brooks is left on the ship, you know, on the Deep Space Nine, mm-hmm. saying like, hey, like, let's try and figure this out. Let's try and, you know, not do this and whatever. His kid shows up again from out of nowhere for the first time, I think, since the pilot. Justin, you did say I think we saw him maybe one other time.
Yeah, we saw him in the episode after the pilot.
Okay, but it's been a good couple of months since we've seen him.
He's in school.
He is.
They have school on DS9.
But then they brought up the whole, like, O'Brien's wife is on Earth now.
Yeah, it's like...
Well, that's why he's coming back. He's on break.
It's all very confusing. I didn't care for this episode.
Okay.
I don't like the kid.
You don't like Jake?
We've already talked about this.
No,
I don't. Maybe if he was in the show, I would like him. I don't understand. Like,
because they got to have that father-son bond. Yeah, man.
They do. But then where is it the other 90% of the episodes? Like, Justin may hate Will Wheaton, but at least it makes sense that he's there all the time because he's there.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Well,
yes, he's been in about every episode. I would say he is there.
He's benched a couple times.
Well, you know how it is. Sometimes you'll have an ensemble.
A couple of times, not 90%. This kid doesn't exist as far as I'm concerned.
It's a space station, Dan. Yeah, come on.
That's true. It's not going to be essential to every plot. He doesn't have to be there on the bridge, you know?
Well, Brooks should be caring for him.
He's a, you know, commander.
I was going to say he's overseeing.
It's true. He's got
hundreds
dual responsibilities.
Of races.
Okay. Then who's taking care of the kid?
O'Brien's wife.
It's Jacob.
Come on. I'm over that. I mean, Quark is fine. You know, I like
Quark's
when
good.
Quark shows up at his bar and plays the games.
Right.
I mean,
Swindle people.
I guess, you know, the games are...
Did you like Odo?
Kind of interesting. Yeah, Odo's fine. The Doctor I hate.
You don't like... So you finally come around to shoot
you
hate
You
now.
Made a comment, Joe, a couple of episodes
might
ago...
Might have to eat your words, sir.
...where you said... Well, I was commenting about the Doctor of the Bakula show.
Yeah.
Enterprise, mm-hmm. and I said, oh, you know, I like the Doctor, and Joe made a comment that, oh, well, yeah, typically the Doctors are always, you know, some of the best characters. Not on Deep Space Nine. This one's maybe my least favorite.
So what was it about this episode that tipped him over for you?
He's just a bumbling idiot. And I just...
It's not his best episode, I agree.
I don't think it's anybody's best episode.
It's true.
I just didn't think it was that good.
Okay.
At all.
All right.
It's one of the worst on the DS9 front.
Interesting.
I give it a C-.
All right. Justin, I want to hear your thoughts. You're the DS9 guy.
I keep wondering if getting frustrated and upset at filler episodes is sort of like being mad at a puppy. Does it really know that it's doing a bad job? No. At the end of the day, does it really matter? I don't know. But this is definitely the most... filler episodes that we've had to sit through thus far, and it's especially frustrating for DS9. I do like the fact that Jake came back. I like the fact that it's actually covering a more character development aspect of, like, okay, he's starting to be interested in girls. Okay,
mm-hmm.
Not getting overly 1960s Roddenberry heavy-handed with it, but.
Well, he's getting his tips from, Ferengi, who, I don't know if you know, don't have the best ideas about women.
I don't know what you mean, Joe.
No, Nog's kind of his best friend. Which
which they've made abundantly clear.
Yeah.
And I think that starts off compelling until it goes absolutely nowhere. And the game portion I liked until it started getting overly complicated and not everything made sense.
Mm-hmm.
And the villain motivation just really didn't go anywhere. It was.
But their sticks are so fun to use. Maybe they get
so many bad implications to be made there, Joe. Don't even start.
Oh, it's pretty obvious.
Yeah, but I'm definitely with Dan on this one. It's a C minus.
Okay, yeah, this might not be one of the best episodes, but I kind of enjoy it. It's kind of fun. Mm. It's very silly. I kind of like the game thing. It's something different. I think that the villains are very over the top, and certainly strengthens a little bit there. And Quark gets some fun things to do, get to showcase him. So yeah, for me, this one's it's not like I can't honestly say it's great, but I find it kind of entertaining in sort of a bad way, you know. And there is some good interactions from the characters that you get to see early on. And Bashir, I will admit, he is pretty bad in this episode and bad early on, but he does get better.
He just serves one purpose right now, and it's
He's kind of pointless. He's very limited, and as they develop the characters, as I said, it's some of the best writing in DS9, but it's a slow burn.
Well, one of the things that did keep it from getting a lower grade for me is that the four of them did have decent interaction.
Yeah,
like you said, you know, and we are getting to know a little more about the characters, so I had to give it something for that.
All right, yeah, I mean, I'm a little higher than you guys, like with a C+. Like, I think it's. It's fun enough for me to keep it elevated.
Okay. But
the way Quark sort of evolves over the course of the episode, poor choice of word. The way Quark sort of progresses over the course of the episode, I liked.
Yeah, Quark's always great. He always has fun stuff to do. Didn't make the IGN's top, though. 25.
Sadly. I'm surprised by that, actually.
Yeah, no, I was surprised, too. And they even joke about it in the number one spot, because he hadn't been set up to that point. Like, we were going to say Quark, and it's like... You couldn't have bumped somebody for Enterprise, put Quark in, like, 24 or something?
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, I think Quark is like... but, you know, there was... When this episode came out, there's, like, a big trend in the 80s and 90s of having these, Justin said, filler episodes. That's a good word for it. Based around, like, games and, oh, let's have a challenge. And, you know, oh, Mama's Family goes on Family Feud. And, you know.
This is kind of a game show thing.
It is. And I'm currently watching a DVD of this show with John Ritter from the early 90s called Hearts of Fire. And Billy Bob Thornton actually was in it, too.
Oh.
But they just had an episode I watched where they play Trivial Pursuit the whole episode.
That's weird.
And it was the worst. It was the worst episode of the series.
It's pretty bad.
It's like, who cares?
Where is this going?
Well, I think the idea in a situation like that is sometimes you get to see characters in a certain situation used to doing something kind of simple.
Maybe.
And that, I mean, and sometimes that works in some shows. Like, I mean, for the lack of a better example, in Dragon Ball, one of the default things these superpowered beings do is they hang out and have picnics. And that's kind of funny. You know, you get to see them do normal stuff. So,
well, that's fine.
You know, I mean, sometimes...
But do something with it.
Mix it up.
You know, I mean, when the Simpsons play Monopoly, you know, they have to call the cops because they get in a big Monopoly fight.
That's true.
I mean, I just... This episode just didn't hold anything for me.
All right, that's fine. Know? I mean, I can't fault you, but I find it kind of entertaining... Because of that silliness that comes with it. Like, I wasn't bored by it at all. But yeah, I mean, you know, as I said, I still feel DS9's got some good stuff. See, once again, it's kind of like the next gen thing. Once people start getting beards, it progressively gets better. It's
who gets a beard?
Cisco.
See, really?
The stuff up here goes down here. Goes for the bald head and beard look. And that's,
interesting.
Those are what I would call the golden DS9 years.
I see.
Well, I mean, I'd say I've got faith, but I don't want to bring back Enterprise, so.
Son of a. No. We can watch that again if you want.
No. I have no interest in watching that ever again. I really don't.
I don't know. The review was pretty entertaining, though.
That was fun, listen.
Well, true.
But we'll do the animated next off.
Mark. Yeah, I think that'll be the next 5-weeker.
Sounds good. But yeah, that's my thoughts. Next time, we'll be doing Voyager, and I can't even remember what the next episode's going to be, but... I'm sure it'll be Voyager. So, you know, we'll look forward to that. Make some Janeway, make some questionable decisions. And but, yeah, in the meantime, guys, comment if you like this episode. You know, looking forward to some other future episodes. And we'll continue on our journey of boldly going.
All right.
So, yeah, I'm going to sign off. This is Merlin, and you guys say goodbye.
See ya.
Take us out.